Vanguard, the Fallen are working their way up the mountain. Their goal is to take Vostok Observatory.
What would the Fallen want in an abandoned outpost?
Things better left buried.
Hello, I'm Justin Haywald, and Destiny's Rise of Iron is on the horizon, and I'm talking with Eric Tay, who's played a substantial chunk of the game. Eric, how much time did you get to spend with the game recently?
I got to spend about 6 hours. Unfortunately, I can't tell you all of the stuff I played, but we can go through some of the things we got to see that we're allowed to talk about. One of which is Fellwinter's Peak. It's pretty cool. It's the new social space. You kind of have to fight your way there, kind of. It's like a mission that leads you to where the Lords of Iron were. So you're kind of fighting your way up to that mountain. And once you ascend to the mountain, you pretty much open up this social space where, you know, Lord Saladin's there. We have a couple new NPCs. We have Shiro, who is an exo who works for Cade 6. Pretty cool guy. And also a new Cryptarch, essentially, Tira Karn. Hopefully I'm saying her name right. If I'm not, sorry, Tyra.
She's not real. She won't care.
But yeah, so she's going to decrypt your Ingram. So she's like another Cryptarch person. Mm-hmm. And then it's just really cool. It's like this kind of snowy mountain with this iron temple where, you know, the Lords of Iron used to hang out at. And like, you know, there's nice fires everywhere. There's wolves hanging out. Like, that's cool. Wolf statues. And they just, you can walk up to them and just hang out with them. And I don't know, I like wolves.
A very Game of Thrones northern kind of feel.
Yeah, some of the armor's kind of got that feel too. So definitely going with the theme there. And it's just, I think it's cool social space.
And I assume you have more vendors there who are going to be selling you new gear.
So the Eververse, there's like a kind of a station that you could buy your emotes and stuff from. There's not any vendors to really buy stuff from. Shiro does give you quests. He does have a few things you can buy from him. And then I guess your bounty person's there. You have enough, but like all your faction people are still at the tower. So you're still gonna, like, there's still reasons to go to the tower. You know, you have to have a reason to go to the tower. So not everything's there. But you know, Lord Saladin's in Fellwinter's Peak now, so like when Iron Banner happens, you won't be going to him in the tower. He's actually in Fellwinter's Peak. But we also got to check out the Plaguelands, which is the new area that kind of opens up. If you guys already downloaded the patch that came out last week, it kind of shows this new area on Earth to the right. That's like, oh, that's wasn't there before. They kind of like added it. And I didn't get to spend too much time there, but, you know, it's snowy again. There's SIVA everywhere, which is kind of like the new outbreak, that the whole reason you're kind of fighting. And I got to try one new patrol mission, and it's pretty cool because you ultimately, one of your teammates, or if you're just there solo, will get to pick up the flaming axe. Mm-hmm. And that thing is just like beast. It's just fun to wield. And like the R2, like the smash, it's just like you jump up, you pound the ground, and just like fire comes out. So that was pretty fun. It wasn't like anything special necessarily in terms of like what I was doing on that patrol event. It was just like slightly different. It was like, oh, you get an axe and you kill some guys, but it feels satisfying to use the axe, obviously. And the space looks really big. Unfortunately, I didn't kind of get to traverse too much of it. But within that space is the new Archon's Fortress, which is kind of like this base that's been built by the Fallen. And there, there's the Archon Forge, which is kind of like a new event that you can play. It's a weird kind of, or I shouldn't say weird, but it's kind of like a hybrid mashup of like a Court of Orcs and a Challenge of Elders. So for anyone that's played that, it's kind of like Horde mode-ish. So you started off with a key that you have to put into the kiosk. And there's different tiers of that, kind of like Court of Orcs. Mm-hmm. And you basically kill stuff until you get to 100%. And each time you kind of populate a like an arena, they're different. They have different kind of enemies. So one could be shanks, one could be servitors. And basically, you kill a bunch of stuff horde mode style until you hit 100%. And when you hit 100%, you're going to end up having to fight like either one or two kind of like bosses. And then once you do that, you kind of finish. And then it's meant to be pretty quick. You have to kill everything within 5 minutes or you fail. And if you die and you don't get revived, you get sent up to the top and you kind of just have to watch your teammates try to like win without you. But it's fun. It's quick. It's fun. And I was told that you will get armor rewards. It's kind of random though. So, and I think the higher tiers you do, there's three tiers. There's like a green a key, a blue key, and like a purple key. We're only allowed to show the green key, unfortunately, but it's pretty fun. It's pretty fast. It's just kind of like, I want to call it somewhat mindless. I mean, like, I'm sure like the tier three gets harder because it's just more demanding, but like the green tiers we were doing was like easy peasy. It was just like kill stuff. And yeah, it's fun to kill stuff, you know, use your supers and whatnot.
You're the core demographic for Destiny. You've spent so much time in the game. I think you were the first person in the office to hit every milestone as it was coming up. But for someone who maybe didn't spend as much time in the game, do you feel like this is a substantial addition of content? Or what is it that might entice people to come back into the game?
Yeah. It's hard for me to say because I didn't have enough time to check out all the content, like all the stuff that you would do after story. I think the story was great. I think that they did a good job because like there's this book now that you basically will fill out. And as you fill that book out for like finishing quests or finishing different types of missions and stuff, objectives, it's kind of like the Moments of Triumph book and the SRL book. But there's tangible rewards. And I think that that's very enticing to people because at least for you, like you don't play that much. But if I told you, hey, if you finish and get to level 2, you're going to get like a box with an item for your class that looks cool and is going to help you out. That is probably pretty compelling. It wasn't like that necessarily before. So I think quality of life and stuff like that has gotten even better from Taken King. So I think that if you are interested, you're going to, you know, keep playing. And if you're already playing, you're going to keep playing. Not sure about the people that haven't played at all, like if it's enticing enough, but we'll have to see.
So Destiny is due out September 20th.
That's correct. According to PSN, it's 2 a.m. We'll have to see. I'm pretty sure that's the time, though.
If you've already played the game, if this is just the expansion, it's only $30, or you can get correct. This as part of the full package for $60, right?
That's correct. And part of the $60 package, if you haven't been playing too much, or you know you have a character that you want to play now that you haven't made yet or hasn't fully leveled up, it comes with a like level 40 boost as well. I think once you boost, you're 280 light, which is about 40 to 50 less than what most people are now.
Well, that's about all the time we have for Destiny Rise of Iron. Do you think you're going to be able to beat Tay in beating this expansion? Let us know in the comments below.